It's again a beautiful day, and it's all about how I made my million show right there on Rant TV and on Facebook. This show is all about bringing up on board entrepreneurs to tell us how they started their business and the challenges they went through. This program is proudly sponsored by GH Wave, Daviba Graphics, NCJ Beauty Plus. My name is Juliet Amuzu, your host. I go for a commercial break. When I return, I do the introduction of my guests. Take and stay. Welcome back from the commercial break, all about how I made my million show right there on Wine TV. Don't forget, we are streaming live on Facebook as well. As I said, how I made my million show is all about entrepreneurs, how they started their business and the challenges they went through. Today I have with me a very young and cute and a handsome man as well, who is in the person of Mr. Lawson. Hello, good evening.
Hello, yes, good evening.
How are you doing?
I'm fine.
Okay. Can you please tell us a little about yourself?
Okay. So I'm Theodore Lawson. I go by that name. And I'm an e-practitioner. So e-practitioner business means that I'm an e-business practitioner and IT project manager. That's my profession.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So how did you come up with this whole business?
Okay. So as an e-business practitioner, let me first correct an impression. This business is not like mine. It's actually like a joint, but it's solely and majority owned and fully invested by the Kara family. So with the Kara family, we have our chairman. We have a chairman. Okay, our chairman is Mr. Raj Kara. Then we have the MD, who's also the son, who comes by name Rahul Kara, okay, and then myself as the COO of the company, yes.
Okay, so how do you raise funds to put into this business?
Okay, so our funding for this particular business has and always remained that from the Kara family. Okay, so we have Kuba Investments, that is our funding company or funding arm of this particular company.
Okay, so how many branches do you have?
Currently, we have about 8 branches.
Can you mention some?
Okay, so we have our corporate head office in Tema. Then we have our big retail office, actually in Graphic Road. Then we have our e-commerce or online outlets based in Spintex Road, here we are. And then we also have Ashiman. Then we have Kumasi. And we have Koforidua and Ho. Yes, that's what.
So how long has Africakart been in existence?
So Africakart, it's a little over 4 years, started in 2015. Yes. So basically this is how far we've come in 4 years plus.
Okay, so what products are in Black Friday? You actually have a day which people buy products, and that day is called Black Friday, right? So what products are they?
Okay, so let me start by saying Black Friday, it's a massive retail day. So where products are discounted heavily to attract shoppers in their numbers to come and shop. It could be online, and we actually at physical shops also. For Africakart.com, what we have in place, it's basically on the electronics we sell. We major mainly in electronics, so TVs are there, ACs are there, blenders, microwave, and we have phones. We also deal in now Samsung phones, Nasco phones, and Infinix phones. We have all range of products like that for customers on that particular day.
Okay, so is it an online business or what?
Okay, so that's a good question. It started as an online business, solely online business. Then it diverted a bit into retail shops also, and so it's looking more like a multifaceted. So we call it a multi-channel business now. So online and offline put together.
Okay. Yes. To my lovely viewers, I go for a commercial break. When I return, the conversation continues. You can stay. Welcome back from the commercial break. And I'm still talking to Mr. Lawson, the COO of Africakart. Mr. Lawson, since you've been in this business and then you've run it for, I think, 4 years, what made you choose this business?
Okay, so my motivation to be part of this business was basically taken from when I had experience what electronic platforms can do outside Ghana. All right, so with my experience outside, having worked in a retail chain, a big retail chain, and with the supply chain department, I saw what it can be if electronically we can make orders, we can make orders and get those products in on time to satisfy our customers. So coming back, I saw this as an opportunity to be part of such a business, which is what we all call online business, with a lot of back-end electronic processes.
So how did you get the idea of this business?
Okay, so I had the idea already, and luckily enough too, with the Kara family, they also had this idea. So it was just the two of us meeting and then having the same common goal to use electronic means or the best technology tools to bring products online to make it easier for people to purchase and have it delivered.
Okay, so in every business, people go through challenges and all that. So have you ever been into those challenges?
Yes, a lot. I mean, from the very beginning, the main concept as to what category to even venture in online was a big problem. And so we tried everything. We tried from fashion. We tried mother care products. We went into hampers. We went into groceries and everything. But now we've narrowed down with time. Through the challenges, now narrowed down to electronics, mobile phones, and appliances alone. Yes.
Okay, so what are some of the mistakes you wish you could have avoided?
Okay, so trust was one of the things we took for granted those times. You know, where customers would, for instance, order products, because we also want to satisfy them, we pushed one way, and you could drive all the way, or the rider could take an item as far as from here, as with Spintex, all the way to Amasaman, and the customer would not show up. Okay, so customer cannot be reached, and you have to come back with a product, you know, just like that, but you've lost, you know, operational time and money, fuel and all that. Those were some of the challenges we saw from the beginning, and those are the risk factors that comes with starting up online businesses here in Ghana.
Okay, so I just want to ask this question. As a successful woman, how do you define success?
Okay, so our objective together with my, you know, the objective actually was to revolutionize how we shop in Ghana. So we saw it as an opportunity. And I think gradually we are achieving that. Okay, we can't say we've reached, we're achieving that. And also, secondly, is to create job opportunities for the youth. And so, yes, why not? We have some youth now, the team has grown, and so definitely we can count that as a success to us. The thirdly one, it's definitely everybody does business for money, right? And at this stage, we are yet to get there where we say, okay, we've made enough money out of the business we are running, yes.
Okay, so why should we choose Africakart over all online shopping in Ghana?
Okay, so as our tagline, anytime you say Africakart, our tagline goes like smart online shopping. Okay, what we believe in Africakart is that shopping has changed. Shopping all over the world is changing, and it should be smart now. Smart in the sense that price competitiveness should be there. Smart in the sense that customers should be able to know their product very well by having enough information to make a purchasing decision. Smart in a sense that customers should be able to choose a partner who is there to support them through their shopping experience and give them after-sales support also, which is guaranteed and that they can enjoy. So we want to make the Ghanaian shopper smarter, or shop smart with only Africakart.
So how do you see Africakart in the next 2 years?
Okay, so our biggest aim, okay, was to reach Africa in 2025. So in the next 2 years, what we want to become as Africakart.com is to become the electronic hub and appliance hub for the whole Ghana. and then gradually extending to the sub-region of Africa. Yes, Western.
Okay, so if someone wants to do business with Africakart, how do the person locate you?
As a multi-channel retailer, first you can find us online at www.africakart.com. We are also on all the social media handles. So we're on Facebook, we are on Twitter, or we are on IG, which is Instagram. Okay, and we have YouTube as well. And then we have a mobile app. So mobile app, Android and iOS, we are on that one too. Okay, additionally, somebody can also walk to our branches, like as mentioned before, any of our branches, and also talk to any branch manager there, whatever business you want to do, buy retail on our site, whatever you want to do, the branch manager can handle it from there.
So you said you're on Facebook, Twitter, in fact, all the social net. So what is the name?
Yeah, so basically the name is Africakart. Anytime you type Africakart, it comes up. Yes, any search of Africakart, it comes up.
My last question, I want you to tell the viewers outside there to advise them. Someone also wants to be an entrepreneur. I want you to tell that person, maybe your last word. Yeah, I just want you to tell that person something. Maybe he or she wants to be an entrepreneur, but he doesn't know how to do it. Okay.
All right, so what I will first say is that we all have ideas. Okay, we all have ideas. We all have our objectives, we all have our goals and everything. But the wonderful thing for today's entrepreneur is that there are tools all over online that is making exposure of your idea, or taking your idea from creativity to reality, or imagination to reality, very easy. So basically somebody wants to sell something, right? You can easily put it online through a Facebook page, on account, Twitter, Instagram, and you're already exposed to people. Okay, so you're already exposed to the world which you want to reach. So it's a lot easier these days. But it's still the principles of entrepreneurship that has to do with enduring the times is still there. So you can expose your thing to 1,000 people. Maybe 1% from the beginning would come through to buy. You need to also look at that, improve upon your processes, and it takes time. And then always take it this way. You, the entrepreneur, you are the business. So your activeness, your continuous pursuit, it's very, very important for you to achieve your goal at the end of the day. It wouldn't come so shortcuts like we think about it, but in the long run, you'll be the winner and live the life that many wish they live, but they can't, because you have done the sacrifice today against tomorrow.
Okay, thank you very much. And then we are grateful we have you on our show. Okay, to my lovely viewers, you heard what Mr. Lawson said. If you have the idea to set your own business, bring it up, motivate yourself, and then you push, you just go forward, and then you be the winner. This program was proudly sponsored by GH Wave, Daviba Graphics, NCJ Beauty Plus. GH Wave is a entertainment blog. For all your entertainment show, just log on to www.ghwave.com, and trust me, you would be entertained. Daviba Graphics is also in as a designer for all your backdrop complimentary card. Just call Daviba Graphics on 020-377-9805. You can see from my look, I am looking very beautiful. And this is from CJ Beauty Plus. She is located at Domi Pillar 2. For all your hairstyle, pedicure, medicure, anything beauty, just go to CJ Beauty Plus. And you can locate her at Domi Pillar 2. And also contact her on 024-644-3575. Many thanks to my technical team and the producer as well. My name is Juliet Amuzu. I'm out.